Hi, I'm Marwa Mabrouk. Today I'm going to share how Android Camera can help you build great camera experiences in your applications. Let's get started. I would like to open our talk today with some information that I call the Android Camera Report. It's a very high-level set of app trends that we took notice of. Knowing this, hopefully you will see why the plans we will talk about next are very exciting. Let's start with some key trends that we're observing among apps. AR filters and effects on social media apps are very popular among users. And we're seeing apps that provide that kind of functionality use the camera API in a new way, by capturing using the preview output stream rather than the traditional capture output stream. And for that, I'll talk about what we're doing to improve preview output stream quality later. Another popular use case on the rise is the use of multi-camera API, which allows apps to use all rear cameras as one logical camera, enabling users to do smooth zoom in and out, utilizing every rear camera powering the phone as one. It's a really cool feature, and it's great to see it getting more support among device makers and more used by app developers. Also, no surprise, the rise of video in different forms, short videos and video conferencing, given the changing times and circumstances we all have been seeing the last 2 years. You will hear about all the exciting features coming with video later on. Finally, we have to mention new devices like the cool foldable phones and large screens becoming an important area for Android in camera apps. And I'll mention how apps will get the best out of our work in that area. Updating you with trends is something that we plan to start doing as a way to provide app developers and device makers insights across Android Camera, with a goal to bring alignment across the Android Camera stack. Innovations in the camera space are amazing, and our goal is to empower the diverse ecosystem to innovate in alignment, so apps and devices can provide users with the most amazing camera experiences. Let's get started by learning about what is new in Android Camera this year. Speaking of the Android Camera stack, let's take a look at the full stack where Android Camera sits between device makers and app developers. You can see Camera 2, the Camera Framework API, on top of it, CameraX, the Jetpack library for camera. We also see what is becoming a core part of our architecture to provide consistency and quality: the test suites and test labs. To the OEMs, we offer XTS, a set of testing suites to cover different needs. They cover a range of tests, from testing the HAL to unit tests for compatibility and image tests for end-to-end camera testing. Alongside XTS, we have the performance class metadata, which informs developers on the device capabilities when they exceed average expectations, so they can take advantage of that. On the CameraX level, we at Google do the testing of the CameraX API ourselves, on the devices, in our labs. And as we find inconsistencies, we add compatibility fixes to provide developers with a very consistent experience in the API across the devices that we test. As you can see from this tag, CameraX is positioned to help you get the best value out of the whole Android camera stack. Being based on Camera 2, apps will get the performance value, packed with all the best practices and knowledge base of the Android Camera team on how to use Camera 2. The CameraX API empowers developers to develop their applications faster and be up and running really quickly. As I've mentioned before, CameraX Lab provides a powerful compatibility layer within CameraX to achieve consistency across the devices that we test. A good example worth mentioning here: apps that use CameraX do not have to worry about new devices like foldables and large screens, as fixes for issues found in our lab will already be included in CameraX. Apps that use CameraX will already get the benefit to work well on those devices without having to make changes on their side. And finally, as a Jetpack library, CameraX enables us to respond to bugs that you report, making the fixes available to you much faster. We're able to test new experimental innovations and support new timely features on a faster launch schedule due to the flexibility that comes with Android's Jetpack libraries. Let's quickly recap the main use cases that were launched in CameraX version 1.0 before this year. Preview, a viewfinder that enables getting the preview on the screen. Image analysis, which enables access to the output buffer seamlessly for use with algorithms such as the ones provided in ML Kit. And finally, capture, which is used to save high-quality images. Version 1.0 was packed with many features to support fast development, such as managing the lifecycle of the camera and other abstractions, while utilizing a lot of capabilities that made image capture easy to implement. Earlier this year, version 1.1 beta was launched, and now the release candidate has just been announced. This version includes the long-awaited-for video capture. It is an important moment for CameraX. Starting with this version, it will be possible to record video and audio with all the same advantages that we just mentioned CameraX brings. With video capture, users will be able to choose which camera to use, whether to have audio or not, and pick the resolution for their video capture. Resolutions can range from SD to 4K Ultra HD, depending on the device. Apps will be able to provide what you see is what you get experience while using the most needed camera controls available, like zoom, focus metering, and exposure compensation. Important to mention here that as part of launching video capture, we're enabling the integration with the Media Store API. So now applications can configure the Media Store output options for the recorder and then configure the recorder with the Media Store output options and start recording with just a few lines of code. This is an example of one of many cases where we are putting a lot of time and attention to the overall camera journey that apps and users need. We are doing this to drive more productivity for developers when it comes to camera experiences and higher quality for applications using the Android Camera API. And as part of version 1.1, we also expanded our CameraX lab, increasing our significant investments in that space. We now test on devices that reach 685 million 28 daily active users, and we include devices that represent different ranges from all around the world. Android 13 will be launched later this year, and we wanted to share with you some of the very exciting features that will be part of that launch. As I mentioned earlier, the preview output stream is important for social media and other apps that depend on effects and AR. We wanted to really improve the quality of the preview output stream by focusing on a number of features in that area. Features will be launching according to Android 13 timeline and will be available through Camera 2 and Camera X. Preview stabilization will allow apps to avoid different results between what a user sees in preview and the outcome after they capture. So no more unexpected cropping in the results after a user tried so hard to get the right composition. Stabilization for preview and capture will be the same, resulting in better consistency. Another feature, jitter reduction, is also meant to provide smoother preview by syncing the camera frames for display during preview with the camera sensor output, avoiding dropped frames and resulting in a much smoother preview. Apps will also be able to use high stream configuration in 60 frames per second in addition to 30 frames per second where supported. Other features coming will also include being able to provide use case configuration to optimize the HAL and torch control through the camera API. Another feature that is coming to Android 13 as part of the camera API is HDR video. The APIs will provide apps with the ability to preview and capture through a common API that will allow them to use front and rear camera. The features will be available through both Camera 2 and Camera X. If you're familiar with HDR video, you must be wondering which of the available profiles that are out there will be supported with capture. A big part of this effort is to improve the consistency of this encoding across devices in Android. We're defining a minimum required profile to provide this alignment. In this case, for capture, that will be HLG10. And additional profiles can be provided on devices based on device makers' choices. To support HDR video, we have taken special care to ensure this will work across the different APIs of Android, like media and display. For more details around those APIs, we encourage you to check what they will share about HDR video. We are working with different partners in our camera stack to ensure support from device makers and apps will grow for this feature. I also wanted to talk to you about an exciting space in Android camera that will be seeing more attention from us in the future, and that is extensions. In prior years, we talked about extensions as part of CameraX. It's important to note now that extensions are available through both Camera 2 and CameraX. Both APIs have 5 extensions already in place: Portrait Bokeh, HDR, Night, Face Retouch, and Auto. Since CameraX can provide faster launches, in the future, new extensions and experimental features will be launched first through CameraX. I would also like to talk about a new approach that we are currently working on exploring. Our focus for extensions has always been to work with the device makers to bring the capabilities of the extensions already enabled on their device through the API. That will continue to be the case with no change. And when and where the device maker has enabled an extension, that will continue to be the default for an app. But what about devices that don't have an extension enabled by the device maker? And what about entry-level devices where it's harder to see consistent implementations across the diversity of devices? This is where we're looking into providing an extension from Google to fill that space. In this case, where there is no extension enabled by the device maker, apps will find a consistent solution as an alternative to fall back to. The extensions from Google will be an all software implementation, unlike the device maker's extensions that are usually optimized with the hardware. It's our aim to make the extensions from Google consistent to work on entry-level devices as well. We will explore this by providing the first extension for selfies, the Bokeh Portrait extension, as an initial extension in CameraX. We will be very happy to see you try it and provide us with feedback through our community channels and processes. We have covered a lot of details. Now, let's recap the important takeaways. Consistency and quality are becoming a core part of our architecture. Our focus includes quality at every layer and across the camera user journeys. CameraX now supports video and audio capture, and it's time to consider it if you haven't already. It's the best way to get the most value from the Android full camera stack. We want to empower innovations with Android Camera by helping our app developers focus on their apps and their innovation, by bringing to them more alignment in the stack and higher quality across the diversity of devices. That, of course, in addition to many exciting features on the way. Please reach out to us through the different channels. It means a lot to us to see your engagement, get your feedback and input, and to continue to collaborate with all of you. We thank you for your continued interest in Android Camera and look forward to partnering with all of you to bring the users of the world the best camera experiences.